I don't think I really need the microphone, but it's for recording purposes. So I'm Ashley, and I'm the NDF board member responsible for these amazing people, and the portfolio is the professional development. So here with me, we've got a few of our regional ambassadors, and these guys are volunteers in their areas, and they create events. They are a contact point for you guys and represent you in all matters, if you have any, with NDF. And I just want to take this opportunity to thank you all for your hard work in your regions, because you've made my job really easy. So the hui that they run were previously called Bar Camps, and these were renamed Regional Digital Forum with the hashtag GlamIT or GlamIT, because we thought that reflected our stakeholders, so the GLAM sector and the IT sector. The planning day that we had was really awesome, and we've got four new regional reps, and they're proving great additions to our whānau. So the Regional Digital Fora were held in Auckland, Canterbury, Manawatu, Whanganui, Northland, Otago, Hawke's Bay and Wellington, and over 150 people attended nationwide. So let's meet the group. So if we go down the line, and if you can introduce yourself and which region you represent, and if you're new or if you've been doing it for a few years.
Kia ora koutou, I'm Lorraine Johnston. I work at Dunedin Public Libraries, and I represent the Otago Southland region. And I'm a newbie. I just started. Was it July we got the training, or August or sometime? So, kia ora.
Kia ora, I'm Meredith. I work at the Nelson Provincial Museum, and I'm the regional ambassador for the Nelson Tasman region. And this is my second year doing this.
Kia ora, I'm Harley. I work at Tauranga City Libraries, and I work in the Bay of Plenty area, but we also cast our eye over the hill to the Waikato region.
Kia ora, my name is Sabine. I work for the Farm Autistic Libraries. I am the ambassador for Northland, and this is my third year.
Kia ora, I'm Cathy Dunn, and I'm responsible for the Hawke's Bay region. I just got co-opted into this because my predecessor is due to have a baby in about 6 days' time. So.
Hi, I'm Janice Chaponsky. I work at Canterbury Museum, and I'm the Canterbury Regional Rep. This is my second year running
one of the week. Hi, I'm Caleb Gordon. I work here in Wellington, so I'm the Wellington Rep at City Gallery Wellington. I'm one of the newbies, only a few months in the role.
So now we're going to go down the line, and I just, you know, this, while there's not many people in the room, you know, we're recording this for prosperity, so it's good that we share this information. So if you guys can go down and let us know what you did at your hui, and what themes kind of were discussed at your hui in your regions.
In Otago Southland, we had a hui at the public library, which was attended by 20 people from as far north as Oamaru and as far south as Invercargill, and reaching out into central. We were really lucky that we have an NDF board member resident in Dunedin, so she came along and she gave us that was Sarah Gallagher. She gave us a quick talk about the board and how the regional hui's fit into the board. We had short 10-minute sessions in the morning, which were pre-arranged, and then we did a bar camp style thing in the afternoon. So we had Otago Museum talk to us about their Māori Taonga digitisation program, somebody from Otago University Library talking about their dams, which had just been digital asset management system, which had just been launched the week before. A representative from the Hokan Archives talking about their Marsden project, and also issues they're having grappling with the whole born digital thing. And then Emma Milburn, who spoke with me yesterday about the Scattered Seeds recollect site, she also talked about that on the day. In the afternoon, our breakouts included topics like the basics, sort of getting started with the whole digital thing, hosting options, community engagement, standards and metadata, open access and reuse, and then a section that I call geek stuff because I didn't know how else to describe it, where they talked about DAMs and digital preservation and digital curation and coding and all those things that were way above my head.
Well, I have a confession to make. In the Nelson-Tasman region, we haven't run our HUI yet, and the reason for that is that things just conspired to mean that our region's very spread out, and it takes a long time for people to get into the centre, into Nelson from Golden Bay or over near the west coast. There was a regional museums meeting which brought lots of people in, and then a month later there was the NetHUI, which was run by Internet New Zealand, and a lot of people from the regions were coming in for that as well. So throwing in a Glamet HUI in that same time frame would have just been, I would be asking too much of people's petrol money and their organizations. So we'll have it in about 3 weeks' time from now. But in the NetHUI, we did run a culture and heritage online session, which was very much like what a bar camp would be and had the same types of people. And one of the really interesting themes that came up at this NetHUI, which was a lot more IT internet people than usually come to the NDF things, which is normally culture and heritage sector heavy, was we realized as we were talking that there was a disconnect between digitizing objects and then being digital and thinking about the world in the digital space. And the IT people were being digital with what they were talking about, and the museum cultural sector people were continually talking about digitizing objects. And it actually took a while to unpick the fact that we were talking about different things, which was a really interesting. And once we realized that, we had some really good quality conversations around that topic.
And Te Ao Moutia, we ran a regional digital forum at our brand spanking new Grattan Library, which was fantastic. And so we managed to attract in all these people from areas in the Waikato as well as the Bay. We had Tauranga Waihi, Matamata, Rotorua, Thames and Hamilton folk. So we're a little bit light on the western Bay of Plenty, but yeah, quite a variety of people, a lot of museum folk and library folk. And just really frustrated that we can't get those IT people coming along, because I think they'd be a real, you know, asset to us. Although I'm not sure if they're so interested in us. So yeah, just finding a way to get IT people into these regional forums would be great. We came up with four themes that people wanted to talk about. One was digitization, and a big part of that conversation was the waning of the kete and the waiting of the new digital enhanced Digital New Zealand site, and there was a lot of interest in that. We talked about planning projects, how to prioritise digitisation projects. We compared and contrasted the Bay of Plenty's Gifford Cross collection of negatives, which were the former owners of the Bay of Plenty Times. That collection was gifted to the library after a major fire in the 80s, and so we're thinking, what do we do about that? And then in the Waikato, they have a whole lot of negatives owned by Fairfax, which they're not allowed to do anything with on a wholesale level, but they have presented a selection of them online. So how did that sort of debate about looking after somebody's assets and then, but who owns it and who's allowed to do stuff with it, and, you know, the risk of acetate negatives and so that. We talked about community collaboration, and there's some questions around the use of Neighbourly as a social media forum. We talked about the role of libraries educating people around digital literacy as well as information literacy, particularly in the post-truth era, just a bit of a hashtag in this conference. And the future of libraries. We talked about the challenges, and consistent was the message. We're underfunded and we have an IT team that are risk averse and don't support us. And so there's a lot of frustration around those two issues, particularly with smaller museums and archives. And then we did a bit of a chat about technical issues. And in the afternoon, we looked at fixity as a practice? How can small libraries and museums get that practice happening with their digital assets? And we looked at PermaCC, which is an archiving site for, so you can cite for legal reasons or academic reasons, and we talked about how that might be useful for maybe backing up the core articles that you put a lot of research into in your kit there, so that you've got it as it was prior to being adjusted into the new digital New Zealand community repository, particularly with, say, community groups that feel like they gave us content so that we could archive it for them. And we can't actually, we don't really know what that will look like in the future, so PermaCC is a potential solution for that.
Last year I ran six sessions in all six corners district library. This year, time-wise, moving and campus time, I ran one session in the Whangarei Library. First of all, I realized that I'm not the foremost rep for the National Digital Forum. I am the Northland rep for the National Digital Forum. So there's a bit of a hint, maybe we do need more reps for areas that are actually bigger than townships. I had six people attend. It was only a 2-hour session because this is the only space I had available in the Whangarei Library, and it was greatly appreciated. It was a mix of public librarians, North Tech, and museum staff. We had some general great discussion just about what the National Digital Forum actually is. In my talks and connection with other people, many people, especially in libraries, actually have no idea what the National Digital Forum does. So I think we might need to do a bit of work with that. I made a start and put something into the Library Life publication that the ENSA brings out about on conference, and brought up what the National Digital Forum does for libraries. In our session, we covered apps that can be taken out of libraries, museums, like pop-up sessions. We talked about cataloging e-material that is not very wide known. That's not, yeah, digital items in Northland. Northland Recollect, Whangarei Library has a site for this, so we looked into this and how we can maybe all resource it in some way. Just looking in a Kaipara, Whangarei, North Tech museums. The item came up, how to create films like YouTube tutorials, sorry, and how to do any of this. So some of us had done others, so it's just more or less in the funnel. It's like we need to go back together and just create little things like this. One thing came up that nothing much happens in the funnels. So could we do run sessions like initial forum session that was really just talking and coming up with ideas and just sharing ideas. I tried to get people to come and say anything, but I had no luck. But just having more often things like regular meetings, I took that back to my manager, who is very supportive, and I thank you very much for sending me down here. But the question is, if we do those sessions, what are we getting out of it? So that was what I got back.
I agree with Sabine. It was really useful just to get together with people from the different sectors or the cultural heritage sector. And again, yeah, we didn't get many putting their hands up from IT either. It was just very useful, you know, just to get together and talk about things that we had in common and other things, you know, in terms of what we might need to share in terms of skills or might need to find other staff, we might need to find to get things done. So we had about 25 people attend our forum, and mainly from our own institutions and public libraries. We did have one from the Waipawa Museum and the Gypsy Rose Tea Museum, which is a charitable trust. So yeah, these there's not much funding. I mean, it's the internal problems of needing funding and staffing to get these projects off the ground, really, in terms of, you know, digital projects, because there's lots of things on our wish lists, but you know, public libraries aren't really even sort of looking to do more digital, you know, in the near future. Which was the presentation we had was from Jessica Moran from the Alexander Turnbull Library, who's helped the MTG with our firstborn digital item, and we've catalogued that, and it was, her presentation was really comprehensive and really interesting. I mean, soon this is just going to be commonplace. You know, it might be sooner for us. I think it'll be a little bit longer for smaller places. I mean, Waipawa Museum just has a website, no database. So it's all very just coming on the street. So the next one I organise, I think I'll probably do it a little bit sort of more grassroots. And so in the afternoon we broke out and talked about the two main issues were copyright and social media, how to get people interested in what we have to offer. And then following on, I hosted a meetup with some local history researchers, and we talked about forming another group to sort of advocate for resources to scan our collections, because again, you know, funding and time, we don't always have them in our own institutions, but perhaps as a combined group we might be able to. So yeah, probably next year I sort of ask for more input from people who I invite to sort of tailor the day in terms of presentations.
Thank you. So Canterbury is very fortunate to have a very well connected and relatively large group of people who are involved in digital humanities and different things like that. This year I decided to hold the HUI out in Ashburton in the hopes of catching some people from some of the smaller communities in our region. And to be honest, most of us took a carpool from Christchurch, but we were able to get some people from the Ashburton Museum and the Ashburton Art Gallery, which is fantastic. And the Ashburton Art Gallery was able to support us in providing a space. So all in all, over 30 people attended. People were stepping in and out over the course of the day, and not everybody wrote their name down, so it's a bit hard to get an exact figure. Some of the topics that we discussed were linked open data and cleaning messy data, but some voices also rang through that the basics are still needed. Some people weren't certain how to catalog, where to store data. Some people were digitizing things just to digitize, but they weren't storing any metadata about that, or even organizing those photos. We talked about collaborating on projects as a region, and there's some tension between people who would like carefully designed and managed and perfect products to be rolled out that we all work on, which are quite labor intensive, and people who took the complete opposite approach were like, nah, just dump everything out there. The fun part will be cleaning all the data and putting it together. So that's a minority voice, but it's a loud voice. And those are two perspectives that are definitely worth considering as we move forward. Now, we were fortunate to have some IT people come to our event from Catalyst, who you might see some of the people from that company running around here. And I did ask them, like, how can we get more IT people? And they also, here's the tips. They said IT people are very practically minded and they want to problem solve. They're fundamentally problem solvers. So they would like a hackathon or some kind of problem that you bring to them, and then they can have time to sit there and work through it with you and do a mini project and throw up something quick. So that's what they're not so much interested in talking and that, so they want to do something. So I think looking forward, maybe we should consider that as a portion of our sessions, because I know that can also be off-putting for people who aren't technically minded.
Yep.
So I think blending something more dynamic and like a hackathon or something with the traditional Barcamp style would be really good.
Great. So, like Meredith, I've been fishing. I actually haven't gone to organise the hurry for Wellington so far. I think like everyone else sitting in front of us, it's all quite time poor. But I have managed to organise some other local meetups and managed to try and connect with people, just because my feeling is if I'm going to organise this, I want to make sure that I'm putting something together and providing something that people actually want to come to. I don't want people to hang out and talk, rehash the same conversations. I'd much rather talk about something useful. So a lot of the feedback I've been getting from people I've been speaking with, there's a lot of interest from people within the GLAM sector in around kind of social media, which I think it's a lot of them are working in museums and galleries and libraries and archives. And they may not be part of those comm scenes, but they kind of want to feel like they want a bit of understanding of how social media works in the comms and how they can kind of help connect into it, because while that might be kind of, you know, professional, they want to kind of be able to still engage in their kind of personal voices somehow. And then likewise, there's been a really similar, some conversations around how they can kind of start their own conversations online to kind of get their expertise and their thoughts and their voices out there. So I think a lot of it is people I'm hearing, the conversation I'm hearing people in the GLAM sector are very much around how we can use digital technologies to connect and share our expertise and voices and experiences. The few meetups I've had in Wellington have been quite interesting as well, because I don't actually, most of the time we don't get IT or GLAM people, we get a lot of public servants. I'm a public servant. Unsurprisingly, Wellington. So they turn into a lot of whining about the government, which is always fun, or mainly funding. But it means they don't have those, they don't have kind of the humanities conversation or IT conversations very much. But the people generating things like born digital documents that go to Archives New Zealand and talking about, you know, we're producing this, but, you know, we came across this problem. So it's a whole kind of a different conversation than all the ones we're having here. It's the ones creating the content that suddenly people are like, oh crap, where did we put that? So it's kind of interesting that those conversations here are a bit different, but we've got government lying all over us, so it makes sense. That's kind of, I'm just kind of looking at how they kind of draw their meaning, because they're the ones that we're all working with. It'd be great to bring them into the conversation as early as possible, or get in on their conversations at the very beginning so that they're best practice from the start rather than at the end, as we've heard a few times mentioned today or the past 2 days.
Would any of the other panel like to respond to some of the other things that you've all been saying, just before I give you your next question? You've been writing furiously. It's great.
Trust me. I really think that the way forward for these regional ambassador type things is to tap into that IT network, because unlike Te Papa and Canterbury and Auckland Museum, most of the places that we work and that we are dealing with we have maybe an IT guy who's looking after our computers, but really isn't doing digital stuff, creative stuff with the material. And although the idea is there and the will is there, the technical know-how isn't. That doesn't mean that those people don't exist in our towns and cities. They're there. We just have to tap in and connect with them. And I really noticed that when I was at this NetHui, which was full of internet geeks, their eyes were lighting up when we were talking about museum and heritage content, and their brains were just whizzing with ideas. And I think that's really the challenge, that we need to pair those two sectors up, because in the regions, they're not paired up in our institutions.
I think that's especially true in the regions where they don't get to, so for example, in Wellington, you have so many events that come to, that someone might say, well, why would your regional forum look like Bay of Plentyone? You know, as you've said, by nature, it's going to be a different kind of forum. But especially in those regions, getting these smaller libraries that aren't as well supported, connected with IT and connected with expertise, is a real critical role for regional groups. And on that note, the Digital New Zealand help documents, make it digital, those kind of things have been, we get a lot of good feedback from regional groups, because they don't have to go out and do that research themselves. They get to just take it, and it's from, you know, a credible source. So when those bigger centres provide that kind of support, it's really, really useful for the smaller regions.
Can I say too, I think it's really important to try and engage Māori communities. I found that we've just got someone on board at MDG as a Māori visitor engagement officer. So that will be someone I can tap into next time. But yeah, I didn't sort of find any link to someone that I could invite this time around. And I think it's really important. We had a couple of Māori people, and they're wanting to know how to digitise their own resources. So that's another thing I'd change for next year.
But I had that last year. I had some Māori people coming to my pahia sessions, and they actually said to me, why are we not coming to Rice? Why are we doing this in libraries or any of those things? I haven't managed to solve that, but that question is still outstanding. So.
This was a while ago, and it wasn't anything to do with National Digital Forum, but the Nelson Museum sent our photographer and a number of staff up to a local marae in Mutuweka, and we just did a sort of a training session on photography and how to photograph documents and objects and what to do with those files, and that was lovely. It was a really lovely day.
So just playing devil's advocate, is that our job as regional ambassadors and in these hui to provide services, or are we about connecting people? And I just can't help but think, you know, where is National Services Te Pairangi? Are we connecting with them enough? So yeah, is it our job collectively, I'm talking about us as you and me, to connect dots, bring people together or provide training? You know, what do you think the key things are for your regions? What are they crying out for and what's not working?
We find that a lot of people give positive feedback that they can have the opportunity to have discussions with people in the same sector and wrestling with the same problems and maybe a step ahead or a step behind. So definitely that connection is useful, but also often the skill shares in the afternoon are also really well attended and really valuable. So my response would be, yeah, a little bit of both.
Mm-hmm. I think mainly for Northland is just getting people to tell you something else that's there that they can access or can get connection again.
Just for Canterbury, I think it's really important that we don't get Christchurch focused. We need to remember that our region is bigger than just the city, even though it's easy. And I think the fact that the majority of the attendees that we had recently were from Christchurch shows that we're willing to travel to these smaller locations. So I think it's completely achievable.
Just on that note, one of the things that's really not working for us in Otago Southland is that I feel a little bit like this guy, in that I'm trying to cover a region which is basically half the South Island, all the way from the Waitaki River down to Stewart Island. And that reaches into central Otago, across into Fiordland, the whole works, and it's somebody else talked about, Meredith, I talked about the travel thing. Mm-hmm. And for members in our region, although it is so much easier to organise something in Dunedin, it's a big ask, particularly for the Southland and those sort of out in the Fiordland, Te Anau, that sort of area, to get all the way to Dunedin is a big ask. And you're very limited as to what times of year you can organise things, because you can never trust the snow not to come on the wrong day. And Leanza grapples with the same problem, in that we have Otago Southland region with Leanza as well. And the number of times we've had events completely munted because half the people couldn't get there because of snow. that we now only organise things sort of between November and May and then keep our fingers crossed. So yeah, I think we probably NDF needs to look at that whole regions thing, and I did an evaluation after our forum, and two things came through really strongly. One was that they really appreciated the short 10-minute bites of people sharing what they were doing within the region rather than having experts come in from outside. And the second thing was to break the region up, because, you know, we had two people from Southland, from Invercargill, and they had, because the evaluation went out afterwards, they actually canvassed people around Southland and Invercargill and through into Te Anau, etc. And they came back to me and said that they felt that there was enough support there if there was a Southland region to get people there. But when it's in Dunedin, you only get a couple of people.
I'm wondering, as we move forward with this, because we've, you know, there's been a bit of momentum now with running these sessions in each of the regions, if maybe we, for some regions, change or pivot a little bit and don't just focus so heavily on a single event in the Nelson-Tasman region for the year, but we just open it up to see what's going to work more. And if it does mean that the ambassadors are driving up to somewhere and spending half a day or doing whatever's going to work, I don't know, monthly meetups in different places, perhaps the model of that one event over the year, it's cool, I love them, but there could be other stuff that might be needed for some regions.
Well, could we do it online?
Perhaps, you know, get together. I'm familiar with Skype, but something like an online conferencing thing, and a bit more regularly.
I had last year and this year the question came up, why is it's not something that they're coming further up? Why is it always in Wellington? Like, for example, the big conference, could we not have some mini India conferences in different areas?
That's sort of regional.
Yes, but that's what.
So do we have a regional hui and then we have other, a Skiltia hui and a, you know, in your regions you guys can just decide how you do it and when you do it. Because you guys know your regions better than we do.
I think the more you add ideas to what is basically a volunteer workforce.
Yes.
Where our employees are already saying, well, you know, we'll put X number of hours into something that's actually not our. You impress the likelihood of the thing collapsing.
Yeah.
I would agree with that.
Unfortunately.
Yeah, totally. Yeah.
I think it was a bit more like every time I ran session, it was just people like us coming, and I don't mean it in a way. I think they were more talking about bringing people in who can show and tell.
One of the cool things, and I'm going to really try and push this, is sharing the stream sessions from this conference and really pushing that and setting up, I don't know, movie nights and stuff where I'll try and do the best, my favorite picks of the conference, because that's a fab resource.
I had given out the link to the NDF YouTube stream, so in my session.
Maybe people need popcorn and ice cream as well to actually motivate them to sit down and watch it.
So before we move on to where to next for you guys, which we've kind of probably covered, are there any questions from anybody? And you have to use the microphone, please, so then it's caught on.
Question for Meredith in particular, with the way your timing has fallen, being able to do your regional ambassador thing 3 weeks after NDF conference, are you looking at ways of incorporating, apart from the videos themselves, is there anything else from here that you are going to be looking at incorporating into what you're bringing back to the regional event?
I think I'll do a little a potted presentation of my main takeaways, and then I'll pick some highlights and run them on a screen. No, what do you have something in mind that I should do?
No, I'm just wondering, because you know, you have in some ways it's an advantage to have just come from this and all the resources it provides, and I just wonder if it's a way, if you do events kind of shortly after, if that's a way of maybe spreading these ideas, because the videos are great, but as you know, it's pretty daunting to be like, okay, here's a 2-day conference, and it's not like people have the time to then spend 2 days looking at the videos.
I'm quite curious to see how it's going to be, actually, and I agree with you. I think it might actually be quite interesting having me just come from here and then still being hopefully enthusiastic and have it all in my head. I'll let you guys know how it goes.
I had promised my group who came that I will report back from this, and I actually had some questions and I found some answers, so I will make a bit of a round email and put maybe some links at Madam Mentor's reporting back from this conference.
When we ran our RDF, we actually created a collaborative document which we added notes to and things during it, and we had to open up it. So definitely I'll be adding some links and things to that and reminding people to come and have a look.
Ashley, where are we going next? I was wondering, should we share some cool stuff that's happening in the region? Or are there maybe more questions?
I just had one question. Well, I'll probably start with the statement, so that's not really my question. Just getting the sense that there is a huge variety of needs and capabilities and ways that people want to address this program. Are you feeling, do you feel like you have the flexibility from the board or from NDF to make some of those decisions? Are there any things that the board should be doing to make it more flexible? Do you need more money? That sort of stuff.
What would be really useful is if there was a national registry of all GLAM, or better GLAMIT organisations, so that we can better target our invites. Because at the moment it's just a matter of individual networks. And there are big gaps in mine, because I didn't get anyone from the Western part of them. So if it was nice and easy that I could just go and spam a whole lot of organisations in my region, it would be great.
I think another another piece of support that the board could give, and I'm not actually sure if they do this, but is communicating with our superiors, just to let them know what we're doing, and that maybe just will smooth it over a little bit more if we're having to do some other obscure, unorthodox type behavior in our normal work day. That would be really helpful.
My point is just going to be that I see the roles more as facilitators. And so I think a lot of it is, I don't, because as well, I'm still learning a lot through the National Digital Forum. So I don't so much want to be the person being like, this is the content I'm going to present to you. I'm more interested in hearing what other people want. So it's just more, for me, I'm happy to sit back and let people connect with me. Well, my name's on the website, they can hit me up that way. So I'm more waiting, I'm a hassling plenty of people as well from my network, being like, how can I lure you out on a Friday night or a Thursday for a drink to talk to people about this? Mm-hmm. But it's just, I don't want to be the one generating content and making those decisions. I would rather people tell me what they want to hear or see what conversations are happening. So it's just more, I suppose, it's more kind of a visibility thing of the conversations and of us in our role, not as kind of just being the people who are there to kind of bring, make sure people come together and making sure everyone plays nicely in a way.
Question I've got relates to a couple of the comments earlier about the use of Skype type meetings, because I think, I've used Skype in my office, and quite frankly, it's average performance depending on the number of users online. We flicked a go-to meeting. We've got five out of three buildings, one in Christchurch, Auckland, and Wellington. Fibre to the driveway or to the inside the building, then copper internal. It's more successful but not perfect. But would that be a medium, or has anyone in the room got a better idea for engaging those that can't travel to some of these broad regions technologically, to literally have the iPad stuck on the wall where they could be, picture the Thunderbirds?
There's another service called Appear.
Appear or Peer.
P-E-E-R. I appear like I appear to you, you appear to me. Appear.in.
You had success with that?
It's good for up to eight.
Yeah.
We use Zoom and Google and Modern Studies. Right across Australia and New Zealand, you sort of set up a camera in each university or each lecturer's office, and you can get up to sort of 12 people right across Australia and New Zealand, and it works a lot smoother than Skype.
Yeah. So challenge to the board might be to investigate a technology that would be useful in the regions.
That's the challenge that the board has to face for itself as well.
Come, go to meeting works well for us. You've got another option there.
Yeah. I think we're both we're looking into Appearant and Zoom.
Yeah, and also just about not just communicating for meetings, but communicating in general, you know, because we have to communicate with each other and we have to communicate with our stakeholders. So it's definitely something the board's looking at. But any ideas?
Just a question to the ambassadors, though. Talking about that technology-enabled meetings, that's really good for business-type meetings, but I'm getting the feeling from the reports from the ambassadors that one part of the value of those regional forums is actually the face-to-face meeting people from outside your usual kind of orbit. So I think we're talking about two different things, the and plus, not either or.
I would agree with you, Bill, but it's
the face-to-face and it's the time. So you've driven out of your city to this place here and you've got several hours and no one's going to walk in and say, we need you on the desk now, or aren't you spending too much time chatting, you know? They're actually setting aside the time. I mean, everyone can watch the YouTube videos, right? But in reality, people don't put in the time. Whereas if you set aside a time and a meet, and then you do it, and they will. Sometimes it's about setting aside the time rather than finding the access.
Yes, Matthew, you can make an observation with the microphone.
It'll be my last observation, I promise. And it is just, well, first up, thank you all for volunteering for this. And I guess it is that aspect of the volunteering that is the big challenge. And I hear the... You know, when you talk about Otago Southland, that's a huge area, and we did try to get a Southland rep, and I think that's one of the things we have to, as a community that spans the country, be quite honest about. If we can only get someone in Otago, and it only makes sense to run something in Dunedin or another Otago town, we can't feel, well, you shouldn't feel guilty about not making it to Invercargill. If Invercargill really wants to do something, we want to support that, but we can't just send someone off to Invercargill to be that community. And I think we've got to, you know, you guys are volunteers, you've got to be, you have every right to be realistic about what you can actually achieve.
I'd like to just ask a question, because I'm from Museums Aotearoa and we've been running regional meetings over the last 4 or 5 years now. And it's part of the value of that is those face-to-face meetings. Do you think there might be, in some of the places where people are a little more thinly spread, some value in, say, piggybacking NDF with Museums Aotearoa or regional Lianza meetings or something like that? I was particularly thinking, you, Harley, you had library people, but you lost the Western Bay. I don't know. Question.
I mean, I think that's a brilliant idea, but again, the problem is communication, and we don't always, you know, I'm in libraries, I don't always get to know that Museums Aotearoa is coming to town until a couple of days beforehand, when I happen to run into one of my colleagues from Toitū or something. When I took on the ambassador role, I actually got myself re-nominated to the Lianza Committee, which I managed to get off a couple of years ago. So that I could at least get those channels of communication going. But I think it's something that I have thought of. It hasn't quite happened yet, but to tag digital forum stuff onto Lianza events and maybe Museums Aotearoa as well.
Did you want to say something again?
I was just going to say, because I met Ashley at Museums Australasia earlier in the year, and that's how I got involved in this. But through that conference as well. I got in linked in with the Immersion Museum's professionals. I know that they were very keen to meet up after the Tadava or this hunger in those groups already to kind of, if you went to the Museum's Australasia conference and you happen to come into Digital Forum, why don't we have a meet up here? Because that way you're kind of seeing who's doing both bills itself opportunity. So I know there's interest in the people who attend these events to kind of like mix and match as they can. So I think it's something that was just a matter of finding a way to take advantage, as you're saying, because it's just hard working out, making sure that we do play nicely with each other.
I think what is going, I really like that idea, Philip, and I think having that freedom for the regional ambassadors to sort of maybe move away a bit from just focusing on those bar camps or whatever we call them now, and being able to tag on an hour at the end of a museum's Aotearoa get together or something, and just kind of play it by ear a bit more and have a bit more freedom with how we connect with our people in our regions and how they're getting together, rather than focusing just purely on that one day. There could very well be more opportunities that we're missing.
Yeah, but how do we find out about those things? I mean, I have to say, I have signed up for so many things because nothing really comes into Northland if not. I mean, I came onto this ambassador role by seeing it on the website.
Maybe just some years call lots of places and talk to people. I don't know.
I think it's in the NDF newsletter.
Mm-hmm.
It's often mentioned. Often
they
report. Maybe we need a glam
calendar. Well, so a couple of things to finish then. One of the things I asked the panel to do was to get an emoji, which Lorraine has already shown hers, so the little octopus.
Yeah.
So I chose this little smiley face because this is how I feel about these guys, and also this little praising hands. Because when I got given the job, I was like, oh my God, what have you done for me, Matthew? But these guys are incredible and do really amazing work in the regions, and you are our ambassadors for NDF, so thank you. So if we just want to finish by going down the line, where to next? So what exciting things are coming up for you guys?
Cool.
And
like
10 minutes. Shoot. And if you want to share your little emojis, do you want to go last, Meredith?
No.
Okay. Lorraine.
I don't know, what's exciting? I'll just share with you what I sort of plan to do from here on in terms of being an ambassador. We had quite a big topic that came up, suggested for our regional digital forum, which I thought was way too big a topic to try and squeeze into a 20-minute, half-an-hour sort of breakout session. And that was institutional change. People wanted to talk about how you change the thinking of your institution from analog to digital, and instead of just having little pockets of people that are thinking digital and everybody else is still back there in the last century. So I'm going to plan something around that. I'm not quite sure how it's going to work yet, but I'm planning something around that to get a have a meetup of some sort to explore that. And we'll probably also try and get a series of lunchtime and or bar meetups, just to talk around issues that might come out of that and any other issues that come up.
Likewise, I think having those monthly type meetups just to get together and chat about stuff is something that I'll be looking at. And that goes in with my little emojis, so there you go, gender neutral, just getting together and chatting and sharing ideas, I think, is really important. That face-to-face, once you've got that face-to-face contact, it's much easier to then trust the other person and call them and rely on their resources. And one neat thing that's coming up in our region is quite a cool collaborative process that's in progress, and it's dealing with Top of the South Maps website, which is a collaborative website with Tasman District Council and Nelson City Council, and it's got GIS mapping data, and it's got all the regional maps for planning and property and services and recreation type stuff, but the Nelson City Libraries are currently digitizing some historic maps that they've got, and they're going to overlay them onto these modern maps. And then once that sort of all happened, the museum will also contribute their historic map collection as well to that website, and we'll tag, hopefully, old photos and place names and stories to that already existing collaborative website that exists, Top of the South Maps. So I'm looking forward to that.
This guy's meant to look curious, although I think he might actually look more like a stunned mullet. I mean, sometimes that happens too at the regional forum. I experience curiosity about what people are doing, and sometimes stunned mulletness around how much they have to battle. Sometimes they're an institution to do what really is what they want to do. But also admiration. I think even for people who aren't in this institution, we've had a lady who's been coming along to our regional forums for 4 or 5 years, and from the beginning to now, she's developed her own sort of business, her own industry of oral history, and not for public, but helping families of dying relatives record their life story and servicing with a really great product at the end of it. What's in the future for us? We are investigating ways that we as a smallish / medium-sized public library can use best practice in the way we digitise our assets and in the way we wrap them up in good metadata, and so that they can fit into anything properly. And that's a newish way of thinking for us, and it's a little bit scary. But it's also a little bit exciting, because we hope that in years to come, some of our analog assets that are beginning to smell a bit vinegary will eventually be just this awesome record of our history that can fit into any kind of package or own generated content or whatever. So that's where we're at.
I will just try to this alien NDF. Of the North, I just keep on trying to spread the word and see where we can get connect people. I mean, yeah, and maybe find somebody in the Whangarei Library who might help as an ambassador, because I think we could do it. If it wasn't just me, we probably could definitely cover bigger areas.
I was walking here this morning and got a text from Ashley saying, what emoji do you want? And I kind of thought it was a typo. So I haven't got one. But in terms of what's next to MTG, I guess we're trying to engage with our customers more. Really like to improve our social media. I've been in this position very long. Come out from the conference so far with the theme of telling stories, so I guess we want to do that better.
Thanks. So I think Canterbury has a really strong community, and to build on that momentum, at our HUI we made a list of possible workshop topics or meetups, and the first one that we're going to run is going to be on the subject of Open Refine, and it will probably be in February. So once I have a firm date, I'll put it in the newsletter. Also, looking forward, I'm going to need to find a new ambassador for Canterbury. You may know that I've been elected to the board, and I can't hold two positions at once, so that's another challenge for me.
Great. So the one I picked was who? Because Ashley wanted someone to pick it, so I was like, I'll take it. But also because I just feel a bit shit for not having it organized. Regional HUI before, so it seemed like an easy way to do it. So going ahead, I'm really keen to organise a regional HUI in the new year, just because I don't know if there's much time really to do it before the end of the year, but just to really kick off the new year with getting everyone back together in the Wellington region and really kind of rehashing some of the conversation we're having here and kind of kicking off. And I'm also really keen to kind of get a regular kind of monthly meetup in some capacity happening, just to kind of keep everyone thinking and chatting, just because we're quite gifted in Wellington, because there's a really rich network of diverse people here who can feed into NDF in interesting ways. So I think we might as well take advantage of that while I'm in the region, at least.
I think that's us. We've got 1 minute to go, so let's So is there any other parting thoughts?
Thank you.
Thank you guys, you're amazing. Thank you. And thanks to this massive crowd for coming. I'm so glad you all came. And yeah, while it's on permanent record, I also want to thank Matthew Oliver for his support for us and the work that the regional ambassadors do. You've got big boots to fill, as I keep saying, you and Andy. Big boots. Yeah, I do. Okay, thanks very much.